Shalom. Bonsoir. Good evening. 11 days ago, the terrorist organization Hamas launched an attack of unspeakable brutality. We've all heard the stories of the murder, kidnapping, maiming, and acts of sexual violence of innocent people, of the elderly, and painful for us to even think of it, of children and babies. I'm sure most of you in this room personally know someone or many people who were affected. Je suis conscient que le fait de ne pas savoir ce qui arrive à des proches, ou de savoir que le danger n'est pas écarté, suscite de l'inquiétude. Plusieurs des histoires qu'on entend sont aussi des histoires canadiennes. On est un pays divers et on a des liens concrets avec des événements à travers le monde. We were devastated to know that it was the deadliest day for Jewish people since the Holocaust, and Canadians were among those killed. Alexandre Luc from Montreal died after calling his parents to let them know he loved them. Ben Mizrahi from Vancouver was known for being larger than life and tried to save people once the attack at the music festival began. Shir Georgi was just 22 when she was killed. Netta Epstein died jumping on a grenade to save his fiance. Adi Vital Kaplun, who had roots here in Ottawa, died on her kibbutz after making sure her killers spared her two young children. And Tiferet Lapidot had Canadian parents. She was just turning 23. May their memories be a blessing. Our hearts are broken, and they break again and again as we hear each story. We are also deeply concerned about the two Canadians who are still missing and may be among those held hostage. We're in close contact with their families and are offering all possible support, including working with Israeli authorities to locate them as quickly as possible. Global Affairs and our embassies in the region continue to work tirelessly to contact and support affected Canadians. And we are closely engaged with our allies and partners to help people safely depart from Gaza, the West Bank, and Israel as quickly and safely as possible. Our government is highly engaged, and members of our team are working around the clock to help impacted Canadians. Minister Joly was in Israel and Jordan over the weekend, meeting with partners and leading our diplomatic efforts. Minister Blair has been ensuring the Canadian Armed Forces evacuation flights are getting as many Canadians out of the region as possible. So far, 12 flights have left Tel Aviv with over 1,300 people on board. And Minister Hussein is making sure essential aid is getting to affected people, including through the Magen David Adom in Israel. Since this crisis began, I've been reaching out to leaders in the region, including Prime Minister Netanyahu and President Abbas, to talk about freeing Canadian hostages, making sure affected people are receiving essential aid and peace, and ensuring peace and stability in the region. The situation remains volatile, and we will not stop being there for affected Canadians. We condemn the acts of Hamas unequivocally, and we are calling for the immediate release of all hostages. Canada fully supports Israel's right to defend itself in accordance with international law, and in Gaza, as elsewhere, international law, including humanitarian law, must be upheld by all, Even wars have rules. Canada will always be a friend of Israel and defend its rights, including its right to exist. Canada will not stand with those who try to uphold on these. I remember well, Erwin, when you taught me these probably, I don't know, 14 years ago as a young MP, the three D's of modern anti-Semitism, the double standards, delegitimization, or demonization of Israel. What happened on October 7th is unimaginable. The indiscriminate killing of innocent civilians is shocking beyond belief. The Hamas terrorists committed unimaginable acts. Je tiens à l'affirmer clairement ici aujourd'hui, comme je l'ai fait hier au Parlement. Le Hamas est une organisation terroriste qui a massacré et brutalisé des personnes innocentes. Ces gens ne sont pas des combattants pour la liberté. Ce ne sont pas des résistants, ce sont des terroristes. Canada has listed Hamas as a terrorist organization for decades, and nothing can justify Hamas's acts of terror and their crimes. Hamas does not represent the Palestinian people nor their legitimate aspirations. They do not speak for Muslim or Arab communities, and they do not represent the better futures that Palestinians and their children deserve. The only thing that they stand for is more suffering for Israeli and Palestinian civilians. Hamas continues to commit unspeakable acts and are trying to instigate further acts of violence against Jewish people around the world, which of course has sent a current of fear throughout Jewish communities. You see, sadly, since this conflict broke out, there has been a very scary rise of anti-Semitism here at home, on top of the past years when we saw already a steady rise in anti-Semitism. There were reports of a possible hate crime at Tannenbaum Chat at Jewish High School in Toronto last week. I've heard stories of people who are wondering if they shouldn't wear their Star of David necklaces, if they should take their yarmulkes off in public. Families worry about what they face if they go to synagogue. And I know you're all probably encountering hateful and troubling rhetoric online. Je le dis sans équivoque, la glorification de la violence ou la célébration de la haine, sous quelque forme que ce soit, n'est jamais acceptable. Our Minister of Public Safety, Dominic Leblanc, is in close contact with the leadership of the RCMP and making sure he is aware of the leadership of the RCMP is aware of actions being taken to keep Jewish communities safe. We've continually improved and expanded the security infrastructure program so that community institutions like synagogues and Jewish day schools can make needed investments. In 2015, when our government took office, this program only had about $1 million worth of funding. Since then, it has grown to over 15 million. I wish it hadn't existed at all. I wish we didn't need it, but we do, and we're going to continue to be there, listening to your concerns and keep investing in ways to keep your community safe. Yesterday, we appointed Deborah Lyons as Canada's new special envoy on preserving Holocaust remembrance and combating anti-Semitism. She takes over for my good friend, a remarkable scholar and advocate for the Jewish community and human rights around the world, Erwin Kotler. Erwin, thank you for having served as Canada's first special envoy, but thank you more for everything you have brought and continue to bring to Canada in so many ways. And Ariel, thank you for giving him permission to continue to work as hard as he does. As Erwin always reminds me, Ariel was quicker to jump in support of my leadership than he was. And I always remember that, dearie. Erwin has been a friend and a mentor and an inspiration for me for many years. And I have been incredibly lucky to be able to work alongside you in so many moments, and I am so glad that we have you here with us, not just tonight, but in these incredibly trying moments, to continue to share your strength and your wisdom with us all. Merci beaucoup, mon cher. Deborah, of course, is a remarkable woman with decades of experience in international relations. She's an unfailing ally of the Jewish community, and I mention her in this respect because I want all of you in this room to know that you are not alone. The work of fighting hate, of fighting Holocaust denial, is not yours alone. Every one of us must confront this challenge together. When we see and or hear anti-Semitism, all Canadians, especially non-Jewish Canadians, need to stand up and step up. That is why all members of our government stand with you unequivocally in your work. Respect for each other is who we are as a country. Our diversity is our strength. In Canada, liberty never means taking away the freedoms of others. It's about living in a way that expands and strengthens freedom for everyone. As Canada, as Canadians, we have proven that a country can be built on and defined by shared values, not by religion or ethnicity, or history, or culture, or language, but shared values. And even though those values are being put to the test once again, I want to say it again. You are not alone. I know this is an incredibly difficult time. There is a saying that Jewish communities have repeated for generations in times like these, and I hope it gives you some comfort now. Gum ze yavor. This too shall pass. All Canadians stand with you in your grief. We will protect your rights and freedoms and security here in Canada so you can continue to live publicly and proudly Jewish lives. We will get through this together, my friends. Merci beaucoup.